The story of Lord Krishna and Sudama. To receive divine boons, we too must give God something. As sadhaks on the path to God realization, many of us wonder how can we receive divine boons such as Shaktipath and Kundalini awakening? How can we have various kinds of spiritual experiences such as seeing the living form of God before our own eyes? The answer to these questions lies in the following story, which has been narrated by Champaklal Maharaj, a direct disciple of Sri Aurobindo and Mother Meera. This story, which is captured in his book Champaklal Speaks, occurs in the Bhagavata Purana, also known as the Srimad Bhagavatam, and was told to Champaklal ji by his father when he was a little child. The story is about Lord Krishna and Sudama, who were childhood friends. When they grew up, Lord Krishna became the king of Dwarka, whereas Sudama remained quite poor. Once when Sudama was going through difficult times financially, his wife reminded him of his friend Sri Krishna, and Sudama decided to pay the Lord a visit to seek his help. Before departing, Sudama's wife gave him a little bundle of rice flakes to offer to Sri Krishna. For being exceedingly poor, it was all that they had. Packing this humble offering, Sudama set off on his journey. When he arrived at Sri Krishna's palace, the Lord was overjoyed to see him. He embraced his friend lovingly and received him with great honor. When the moment came to hand over the gift, Sudama, seeing the rich opulence of Sri Krishna's palace, started to feel extremely ashamed and was unable to offer his poor gift of rice flakes. He tried to hide the bundle under his arm, but the all-knowing Lord Krishna saw it and snatched it away. Opening the bundle, Sri Krishna took a handful of rice flakes and ate them with great relish. Then he ate a second handful. But as he was about to put a third handful in his mouth, Queen Satyabhama held his hand and stopped him by saying, "Lord, with the first handful you turned Sudama's hut into a palace. With the second you gave him riddhi siddhi, that is prosperity and spiritual attainments. If now you take this third handful, you yourself will have to go to him." The moral of this wonderful story from the Srimad Bhagavatam, as Champaklal ji explains, is that even if the Lord desired to help Sudama, unless Sudama himself offered something to the Lord, he could not bestow Sudama with anything. This is why, in order to grant Sudama the financial help he needed so badly, the Lord had to snatch away his tiny bundle. And so it is only when we make an offering to God of our ego and its accompanying negative qualities of selfishness, lust, greed and anger, it is only when we make an offering to the Lord of our hard work or purushartha to conquer this ego, it is only when we devote our time and energy to this task and thus make an offering to God of our time and energy, it is only when we devote our money in trying to conquer our ego by spending it on performing selfless service or nishkam seva of the Lord's creation, it is only when we thus make an offering to the Lord of the money and the resources at our disposal, it is only then that God bestows His boons, for it is only then that we have created the necessary patrata, the required capacity, the required worthiness to receive the Lord's profound grace. Proceeding forward in this way, ultimately when we surrender our entire ego and our all to the Lord, only then does He abide eternally with us in Samadhi. As Sri Aurobindo once explained to a disciple, in order to see the divine face to face, there must be a complete consecration of everything to the divine without allowing pride or any kind of attachment to intervene. Cherishing this supreme truth outlined by Sri Aurobindo and the Srimad Bhagavatam in our hearts, let us meet again in the next video.